In this video, I will explain what you must know to be successful with ankle block for bunionectomy. And in contrast to common practice, you don't need a full ankle block. And there are some specific tips you can use to make it a success. So let's get started. A bunion is an osseous bump that forms at the joint at the base of the bone, and it occurs when some of the bones in the front part of the foot move out of place. This causes the tip of the big toe to get pulled towards the smaller toes and forces the joint at the base of the big toe to stick out. Surgery is the only way to fix this. And regional anesthesia, ankle block plays a huge role in ambulatory surgery. You don't need to know osteotomes, myotomes, and dermatomes to practice regional anesthesia. That is a misconception. Every textbook, every manual of regional anesthesia, every article teaches you that you need to know this, and it's impossible for you to construct nerve block techniques to match the osteotomes, myotomes, and dermatomes for each individual surgical procedure. What you do need to know, however, is which block to use for specific surgical procedures. You don't need a saphenous block for most forefoot surgery, and that is because the saphenous nerve ends before it reaches to the distal foot. The article by Lopez and colleagues have clearly documented this in very nice dissections, but the saphenous nerve very rarely reaches to the tip of the toe. Okay, let's briefly review the anatomy. That is a tibial nerve, or a posterior tibial nerve. Posterior tibial nerve is a very large structure, which really means that, number one, that's the first nerve you need to block when you're performing an ankle block. And number two, it is the most important block to anesthetize when you need foot anesthesia, because it anesthetizes or covers the sensory coverage for most of the foot. The tibial nerve is located behind the medial malleolus, and if we turn our attention to the ultrasound image, here we can see the medial malleolus, and that's the image on the reverse ultrasound anatomy from the NYSORA nerve block app, and that is the flexor retinaculum on the reverse ultrasound anatomy illustration. And as you could see here, these are the posterior tibial vessels, the artery and the veins, and the posterior tibial nerve, which is enclosed in that flexor tunnel. And there it is, the nerve in the flexor tunnel next to the posterior tibial artery in the vein. And if you look at the cross-sectional anatomy, that is the medial malleolus. And we turn our attention now to the flexor retinaculum, which is over here, and the tarsal tunnel, which is underneath. That is the tibial nerve. You can see it's a rather large structure, and it's positioned immediately to the posterior tibial vein and the artery. So when we perform this block, the posterior tibial artery is the main ultrasound landmark for this block. And here's the reverse ultrasound anatomy that explains exactly what we're trying to do with this block. Here we can see the transducer, which is placed just above the medial malleolus, and you can scan a little bit proximally or distally, wherever you see the nerve the best. The needle insertion is usually out of plane, but if the patient's position is such that you can use in-plane needle insertion, you can do that as well. And then if you look at the reverse ultrasound anatomy, where you can see the flexor retinaculum on the medial side that attaches to the medial malleolus, and here you can see also the tarsal tunnel, which contains the posterior tibial artery, couple of posterior tibial veins, and the posterior tibial nerve. The gist of the technique is that one way or the other, the needle needs to breach the flexor retinaculum and enters inside the tunnel. Injection of the local anesthetic into this space then pushes the nerve away to safety from the local anesthetic. 3 to 5 milliliters or 0.5% bupivacaine is the most common local anesthetic and a dose that is used for this particular block. So if we can see a typical bunion, plus here we have also deformity of the second toe, which kind of makes it more interesting, but what you need for coverage of the most important surgical aspect of the procedure is the posterior tibial nerve. But also we will need deep peroneal nerve for this web space over here. And deep peroneal nerve also anesthetizes intrinsic muscles of the foot. So if the excision extends over here, having a deep peroneal nerve anesthetized will give you a greater degree of comfort. And finally, we need a superficial peroneal nerve, which we block above the ankle. We will not talk about deep peroneal nerve and a superficial peroneal nerve in this video. We will leave that for the next video. And here's a very important tip. Once you anesthetize the tibial nerve and a deep peroneal nerve, you don't need to fuss with the superficial nerves, because even a simple infiltration of the local anesthetic subcutaneously will cover the superficial peroneal nerve. And if there are any branches of the saphenous nerve that may reach that distally, which it is a very rare scenario, as you will see. You can learn or teach NYSORA's 60 standardized techniques directly from the NERVE Block app. Don't do or teach NERVE Blocks without it.